This is Robert Picardo, and you're watching The Planetary Post.
We are here in Washington, D.C., the night before the March for Science, and all these wonderful people are making posters that they're going to carry tomorrow. Can I ask you all to please hold up your work, hold up your posters so we can see? We all have one message to deliver tomorrow, and that is that science is universal. May I have a look at your work? Science is the poetry of reality. I don't think I'm quite intelligent enough to get it, but I know that I like it. We are blinded without science. I love this. Face brings out the best in us. I can't argue with that. Your friend painted this.
Yes.
Absolutely beautiful. So these are obviously stars and asteroids mixed in with the stars.
Yeah.
This is not drawn to scale, correct?
No.
Okay. You have all this area here where you're going
to
put text.
Yes.
Have you considered what that text might be?
I was thinking science is universal.
Why don't we put science is universal and I love Bob Picardo on Star Trek, all right? Now the first decision you have to make is, are you gonna go landscape or are you gonna go vertical? Opinions are not facts. All right, this is gonna be amazing. I think I'm done. Here we have the message. Here we have the universal message. Now this young man, may I hold this up? This is, frankly, a much better job than I did. I'm afraid that I'm going to have to take this. Is that all right with you? You can carry this tomorrow, and I'm going to carry this because it's a better job.
I think I'll carry this. Sorry.
Do you have any idea who I think I am? We're here at the March for Science in Washington, D.C. I have the poster that you saw me make last night covered with a plastic bag because there is a little rain. However, this is far too enthusiastic a crowd to have their spirits dampened by a little rain. How many people do you think are here? Look at this. We're going to hear our fearless leader, Bill Nye, speak in just a few minutes up on that stage. Until then, why don't we walk around and see if we can talk to some of the marchers. All right, we're grooving here at the March for Science. Guys, can I see your posters, please?
Woo-hoo!
Let's hear it for science!
Science!
Hi, can I see your poster?
Oh, sure.
We know this guy. A shout out to Neil Tyson.
Trees are speaking for the planet.
The trees are speaking for the planet, which is why I should shut up. I'm talking to my friend Esther, and Esther is a member of
the Planetary Society.
That's right. See that beautiful pin that's right there? What is the most exciting thing for you today?
Oh my gosh, to be surrounded by all these people celebrating science and advocating for space exploration. It's amazing.
Science! 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 Science!
I'm here with some undergraduates from Columbia University. They took the bus down here to be at the March for Science. I love your poster. I'm with her, the her being
Mother Earth.
Mother Earth, who we're celebrating as well today for Earth Day.
The process of science has enabled humankind to discover the laws of nature. This understanding has in turn enabled us to feed and care for the world's billions.
It's been a great day here. It's wonderful to see how many Americans are passionate about science and are here today to show their passion. There have been a ton of great speakers. Bill's speech was great. Now we're going to march.
Science is universal.
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 We're about to march.
Okay, that's the Capitol building. It's wonderful to be in the middle of all this excitement. Americans who care about science.